What's up, y'all? This is Travis from Chasing Anthems giving you guys another reaction video. If you are new to the channel, thank you guys so much for joining us today. We appreciate all the love and the support that we've been getting from this reaction channel. It's been so much fun. But with that being said, if you are new, please consider subscribing, hit the bell to be notified of future videos, comment, share, do all that great stuff because we greatly appreciate it. It helps us out so much. The reason why we started this reaction channel is because we are original music group. We're producing music on a regular basis, and this is our latest single Over It that is going to be dropping this Friday, January the 14th, on all streaming platforms. So please be sure to check it out. On this channel, we're going to be dropping reaction videos. We got a music video in the works, so we appreciate all the love and support and helping us out. But in the meantime, we're going to keep checking out other great artists, and a lot of this stuff is based on your suggestions. So if you like this video and you want to see other artists similar to today's artists, or if you want us to go in a totally different direction, we solely rely on your feedback. You'll notice I try to comment back to everybody as quickly as and as fast as possible. If you have suggestions, hit us a link in there. And then you want to make sure you see those videos, so that's why you want to subscribe. But with that being said, enough of that. Today we're going to be checking out Pantera Walk. Now I know a lot of people say in the comments that it's not genuine, it's not real when we react to when I react to this and other reactionists react to it. I can't speak for anybody else, but I can speak for myself. I know this song. I've heard this song before. I'm not unfamiliar with it. I don't know much about Pantera, other than they are in the heavy metal space. But I've never seen this music video until today. So we're going to be checking that out for the first time together and experience it live. I'm going to be commenting. I'm going to be asking questions. I'm going to be leaning on you guys to fact check me if I say anything out of line. So with that being said, let's get into it. Let's check out Walk by Pantera. Is that not one of the most recognizable heavy metal riffs? Can you think of anything else? I mean, I don't know a lot about this space. You know, I'm starting to learn more by doing these videos and stuff like that. But this seems to be one of the most recognizable riffs that I can think of. Not the best, not maybe the most complicated, but one of the heaviest. I don't know. Let me know what you think below, but in the comments section. But to me, this is there, man. This is it. You know that it's about to go down, and we're gonna get into it. Hey, you see how far that dude dropped? Let's go back there real quick. That is a young man's game when you drop from that high. What's the tuning, the natural tuning in this song? Is it D, or do they go even lower? You know, I'm not sure if is it Dimebag, I believe that's his name, is playing a 7-string. I don't know. I don't think so. But I know, you know, in the heavy metal space that there's definitely some pretty low octaves that they can get into. So when I say heavy, I mean, I'm sure there is probably from an octave standpoint much lower tracks than this, But as far as just like energy and just weight that goes along with it, part of that too, in my opinion, has to do with the rhythmic pattern of that riff, right? Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. It almost kind of has a Marilyn Manson sound to it, but obviously I believe this song came before The Beautiful People, but to where it's very just stop, go, stop, go, and the drums go along with that. You hear a lot of other, you know, faster, heavy stuff that might just power through that, but there's something about that, like, syncopation in the breaks that just creates a suspense that leads into those big choruses. And then obviously the chanting and the call and response type vocals creates this very, like, you can't not pay attention to this, right? Like, it's created a very captive audience. There's a lot of shows you could go to and, you know, bands are playing and you can easily just kind of pass by. But like, this would be an attention grabber, and which makes it, to me, stand apart from others. I don't know how you feel about it and what makes it stand out to you. But I mean, that's from an outsider's perspective. That's what I take away from this song, which makes it unique from the others. Spread. Walk. What did you say? Read. Spread. Walk. Are you talking to me? Are you talking to me? Also, obviously, messaging has to do with it. I don't know, when you have a word like respect that is repetitive, that's something people can get behind. I don't know what he's referring to. I'd be curious the intent or the meaning behind the song. All songs have a backstory, right? And I'm sure this one's got quite a backstory as well. So yeah, let me know in the comments so I can learn more about this particular track. Run your mouth when I'm not around. It's easy to achieve. You cry to weak friends that sympathize. Can you hear the violins playing your song? Those same friends tell me your every word. Is there no standard anymore? What it takes, who I am, where I've been, belong. You can't be something you're not. Be yourself. Stay away from me. A lesson learned in life, known from the dawn of time. I was trying to pick up on the lyrics. Be yourself, stay away from me. I think the message is about demanding respect and not trying to be something you aren't and being fake. I'm sure that this, you know, they have experience in this area, or there's something, or if it was about something else, I don't know. I'm just kind of curious. I'm just trying to pick up on that. The one thing I think that this song is lacking a little bit, but I'm not sure it's the actual song per se versus the streaming platform, right? And so, you know, not all streaming platforms are the same, especially YouTube. I know if you listen to like this track in Spotify versus Apple Music, it might sound a little bit different. Obviously, the clarity would be a lot better than on YouTube. With that being said, I think the bass is missing a little bit here. I would love to hear the bass being brought up in the mix, because this is such a heavy song, and I'm very impartial to playing the bass players and having that really heavy low end. I think that's a little bit that's lacking. When you hear a lot of just like distortion, it can be a little more on the tenny side, on the high end register as far as, you know, your equalization goes. I would love to hear that low end be brought up and to complement that, and I think. And you can see with all those stacks, man, it's probably just getting blasted in their face in a live setting. I'm just not getting that same volume coming across this particular platform. So I don't think it's the artist per se. I think it's just the platform. But, you know, these beats do pick up low end pretty well, but I'm not hearing it great through this YouTube video. Respect. Walk. Are you talking to me? Respect. Walk. What did you say? Respect. I think this is just the YouTube version of it, because even this solo sounds really thin. So, once again, not knocking the band at all. Just the mix is not coming across great. So I'm gonna have to check it out on another streaming platform to fully appreciate this. This track sounds very familiar, and I'm curious if it was like on Tony Hawk, maybe one or two, or maybe even GarageBand, or not GarageBand, Guitar Hero or something like that, because it just seems very too recognizable to not have been on something like that. I don't know. Comment below if I'm right or wrong. That solo's bad. The two-handed sliding on there, that was just sick. Can you think of a better guitarist, at least in this space, than Dimebag? I know he is adored, and rest in peace, you know, he no longer is with us, but he's just a phenomenal player. You know, so many guys play that his replica guitars because they're just in awe of the ground that he laid as far as in this space, and you know, others, guitarists I respect him outside of the metal genre. But yeah, who's your favorite metal guitarist, if not Dimebag? Fading out. All right, that was Pantera, Walk. What'd you guys think about that? For me personally, I think it blows me away the amount of energy that these guys in this genre put into their craft. I'm exhausted watching this. They're playing, you know, and I get it. Like, when you're in a live setting, you have that energy and stuff like that from the crowd and the ambiance and all that kind of stuff that's adding to it. Man, but to be able to just do that for an entire show, to be headbanging that way, you can see they're just drenched in sweat. They're leaving everything out on that field. And I can only imagine if you were there, how much energy you would pull away from that, and just seeing the enthusiasm from all these other fans that are just digging it. So I give props, man. You know, it's one of those things I'm always looking for as an artist, and how I can improve. And this is definitely one of those things, is like putting it out there on every show as if it's your last show, as if you're never going to play again. You know, and so I respect that. And I love to the originality that Pantera brought to this track that I mentioned, you know, in the video, that syncopation and then those breaks in there, I think is really powerful. And it sets that track apart from a lot of others that would just plow right through it as fast as possible to get in as many notes and do all that kind of good stuff. But overall, this is a great song, really powerful. I'm curious with the meaning of the track, because I always like to know, you know, what am I getting into? But from a musical standpoint, I think it's extremely dynamic, and it's fun to check out other genres that I'm not as familiar with. With that being said, thank you guys so much for tuning in, checking out the video today. Like I said before, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe, hit the bell to be notified of future videos, comment, share, do all that kind of good stuff, and go check out some of my original music. I'm curious what you guys think. January 14th, dropping Over It, but we already have a ton of other original music out there on all streaming platforms at Chasing Anthems. We appreciate you guys checking us out, showing us some love. With that being said, I'm going to catch you on the next one. Peace.